Hear my heart, my word falls into the river of love, chapter 58. It wasn't that Su Ying knows that her engagement with Hua Chen would break one day, but in her thoughts, the one to suggest breaking the engagement would always be her. She had anticipated Hua Chen being the first to bring it up. She set down her cup of water and furrowed her brows as she stared at him. Hua Chen, what do you mean? Hua Chen commented, I think I expressed myself very clearly. I want to break our engagement. Su Ying smiled sharply, anger barely restrained. It's broken just because you say so? Even if you want to break it, then it should be me, because I broke it off. It doesn't matter to me. If you have an easier time accepting it with that, then you can tell the others it was you who broke the engagement. You. Su Ying glared at him in rage. Hua Chen, you're only 28 this year, right? Now's not the time for joking around. We held an engagement feast with Vampire just last month, yet now you speak of wanting to break it off? What would others think? What can they think? Marriage can also lead to divorce. Besides, we're only engaged. Everyone is an adult and can understand. Truly ridiculous. At that time, it was you who insisted on being together with me. So what happened now? You fall for another woman? Hua Chen stared at her, his gaze serious for the very first time. Su Ying, ask yourself this. Do you like me? Su Ying pursed her lips and remained silent. It was only a good while later that she said, Fine, you want to cancel the engagement. Go tell your parents and my parents yourself. She picked up her purse and left without a second glance. Thinking of the two pairs of parents, Hua Chen felt a slight headache. Though, for some reason, his heart actually eased significantly. After Jin Yan returned from France with her show, she received manager Yun Yan's notification. It said that Sass Factory's completed collection would be hit the market ahead of the schedule. Yun Yan, it's like this. There's a relatively large anime festival in March. We have always had a collaborative relationship with the organizers, so this time, we're thinking of taking advantage of this anime festival to start the collection there. I'm wondering if you're willing to go there and attend signings? Footnote 1. Before I get backlash for calling it an anime festival and not anime expo, the conventions are called festivals in China. And a footnote. Yin Yan. If you aren't willing to show your face, you can wear a mask, too. The publishing house had previously also mentioned signing autographs. But Jin Yan hadn't dared to go to heavily populated areas as she would unavoidably have to touch men. Secondly, she wasn't willing to show her face. Even though she could wear a mask, this didn't go along with her aesthetics. At present, the paparazzi had already reviewed her pictures twice. Despite being deleted very quickly, tons of people had already saved the pictures. In addition, her misandry had improved significantly. If she was careful, there shouldn't be any problems. Tangzi. Would the autographs only be for the satisfactory career collection? Yin Yan, of course, readers might still bring other books for autographs. We'll try to limit the time as much as possible. The signing is only half an hour long, with possibly a small interview beforehand. Tang Zi, then can I request that the host and the staff members by my side all women at the time? Yin Yan, this is a small matter can be talked over with the organizers. Tang Zi, if it's like this, I will participate. Yin Yan, fantastic, hugs. Since the start of Tang Zi's career 5 years ago, this was the first time she was participating in a signing. As a crew manager, Yun Yan felt especially excited. Once we finish planning the specific schedule, I'll send it to you. I'll directly discuss the business contract with Chief Lin later. Tang Zi, okay. Yun Yan, kiss. Yun Yan, oh, that's right. Let me ask for a bit of gossip. Is it Adam's Master He's request that the host and staff members are all women? Shy. Tang Zi, yes. Yun Yan, Ernest Master He wants to keep you to himself. Smile cry. Footnote 2. The phrase in Chinese has no English equivalent. The closest literal translation is something like watches you closely and strictly manages who you're in contact with. So, wants to keep you to himself is a liberal translation I'm sticking with because it conveys the meaning of the phrase best, in my opinion. And then footnote 2. Tang Zi, yes. Smile cry. Shifting the blame like this and charging the crime onto her show, Jin Yan's heart didn't twinge in the slightest. Furthermore, she was even a bit proud. Lin Zhen soon contacted her and asked if she had actually agreed to attend the signing. She was extremely shocked. These past few years, Jin Yan wouldn't even bear to post pictures of herself on Weibo, but suddenly convinced her to attend an autograph session. Jin Yan remarked, people cannot stay the same forever. You and I are different. I am progressing every day. Lin Zhen was silent. In the end, why she had to make this call, this truly was Indian's one fail to the point of bursting. Footnote 3. Moonclips comment. This is like a common phrase where it means one is full and has nothing to do, and now sticking their nose into others' businesses. And footnote 3. first genius cultural sign, the organizers of the AMA Festival quickly announced this information. Naturally, since it was the first time teacher Tang Si was participating in an autograph signing, it caused massive uproar among her fans. The readers strived to be the first to express their excitement, fearing to be the last to do so. Heavens, teacher Tang Si is hosting an autograph signing. This is simply a series that won't end in a lifetime. Big God, promise me, when the moment comes, don't wear a mask, don't wear a mask, don't wear a mask, okay? Don't wear a mask plus 10,086. Last time when two princes from Voice came to an anime festival to sign autographs, they both wore masks. Goodbye. But then people, can there be a little basic trust? Goodbye. My teacher Tang Si is hot and beautiful. Definitely won't wear a mask, right? Right? Being all for numerous readers' opinions, Jin and Daofang released a Weibo post in response to everyone. Tang Si, V. Don't worry, I won't wear a mask. Shy. The masses felt relieved, but Nan Si, feeling wrong, sent her his Weibo message. Nan Si, V. I sense the number of love rivals will suddenly increase. Goodbye. In all honesty, hubby, are you not worried that when the moment comes, you'll have little fans coming to milk up the festival? Laughs up sleeve. This is perfect. Remember to tell them to strengthen security. Ha ha ha. At Tang Si, teacher, draw your blade. Great God, Nan Si is mine. Hubby, since you got together with teacher Tang Si, you don't love us anymore. Goodbye. Every waiver post of yours nowadays all has something to do with her. I'm not pleased. Smile. Once Herschel read his fans' comments, he called Jin Yan, deeply worried and sick at heart. Next month's autograph signing. Better not go, okay? It seems that danger lurks on every side. Jin Yan did not reply. How about I hire you two bodyguards to follow you? Jin Yan was a bit dumbfounded. It's not a bit excessive? If you think it's excessive, I can have them dressed as staff members. Jin Yan was silent. This wasn't the problem, okay? I will speak with the manager and have the organizers strengthen security. Hunter still was not very reassured. Is their security reliable? How about I transfer over a team of our Starlight General merchandise security guards? They're all veterans of 100 battles. Jin Yan suddenly had the feeling that she was an important political leader from some foreign nation. A moment later, she said into the receiver, I think you seem to be too confident of your charisma. Hushed was silent. Is that not so? Young lady is now just really full and insane. But on the day of the anime festival, Hushed realized his anxiety was a bit baseless because at the anime festival, not only did the organizers give security guards, they had also mobilized police officers. The scale of the anime festival was massive with tons of people attending, so a team of police officers were already there early in the morning to maintain law and order. Jin Yan also got up very early that day. The contract stated time to be 10:30 a.m., so Lin Zhen said she would meet Jin Yan downstairs at 9:30 a.m. to pick her up. Jin Yan attached a lot of importance to her first official meeting with her leaders. She soon found for her cloakroom, having already tried out two outfits. Ultimately, she chose a light yellow coat of medium length that represented spring fashion the most. She matched with a pair of similar colored high heels. Beneath the coat, she wore a white lace blouse and a beige midi skirt. Standing in front of the mirror to look at herself, she tied a white bow around her neck. The baby bow was very eye-catching, making her look smart without losing an ounce of sweetness. It became the focal point of her outfit. After Jin Yan applied her spring day makeup look, she grabbed her purse and left the apartment. Lin Zhen had just arrived downstairs and nearly prevented herself from whistling upon seeing her. Beautiful Lady Jin, your male families will definitely experience a sudden increase as of today. I finally understand the emotional crisis Elder's Master He is feeling. Less talking, the venue is quite full. If you arrive late, the organizers will have to say we violated our contract. You have to pay the penalty. Lin Zhen was silent. The road was indeed backed up with traffic, but Lin Zhen and Jin Yan still arrived at the venue on time. They hadn't even gotten out of the car when they were welcomed by her manager and staff members, who were waiting outside the car for them. Jin Yan had been Jin Yan's manager for nearly 3 years, and this was the first time she saw Jin Yan in person. Frankly speaking, Jin Yan was indeed quite breathtaking. There was no need to even mention the other staff members, who had all gathered around for autographs and a group photo. Escorted with a crowd of staff members, Jin Yan arrived at the venue safe and sound. When she entered, people caught sight of her and began surging forth. Security guards also rushed forward to maintain order. Continuous shouts of Tia Tang Zi rang out while Jin Yan made her way to the lobby nearby. The host of the event was indeed female, and she had used her heart to cosplay Zhang Ke. She was rather moved while briefing Jin Yan about the process. Afterwards, she went on stage to declare the start of the interview. The area beneath the stage was packed with spectators, who held all kinds of digital equipment in their hands. Their camera lenses were all focused on stage at Jin Yan. Influenced by the atmosphere, the host exclaimed with anticipation, I'm very honored to see teacher Tang Zi here alongside everyone else today. Great God, Tang Zi is truly and suddenly beautiful, yes? Yes! Jaden laughed and thanked everyone. The host then asked, in Teacher Tung's manhwa, the protagonist dresses very fashionably. In Teacher Tung's songs also dressed as numerous people have imagined, a very fashionable person. I believe that it's not just me who wants to ask this. In terms of styling outfits, just exactly what do we have to do to be both stylish and beautiful? Jin Yan explained, every season has the popular seasonal elements. This can change at any time, though. I feel you can't blindly pursue a trend. Instead, you should create an outfit that best suits you. Of course, this requires skill as well. For example, yellow and green represent spring. If you wear these colors even simply as accessories to add a finishing touch, the outfit will be brimming with a spring flair. I just took note of your high heels. They are really all especially nice, and it even has embellishments. The golden little bird is very cute. Jin smiled and commented, yes, I also love this pair of high heels. The light color matched with the cute embellishments create an exquisite yet slightly innocent style. Many others might not like wearing accessories much, but in my opinion, I would definitely suggest everyone to wear accessories because even one small accessory can make you look entirely different. For example, I am very fond of silk scarves. Ah, your silk scarf promotion was all like general merchandise. I'm extremely looking forward to it. Me too. Then, is Ellis Master He accompanying you today? The fans outside went wild as soon as the host asked this question. Some of them even shouted out at the name Nang Si. Jin chuckled and stated, I think we seem to have gone off topic. My manager looks a bit green in the face on there. We better talk about my manhwa instead. Yin Yan stood there with a dumbstruck face. She didn't. She also wanted to know about Ellis Master He. The anime festival's on-the-spot interview had yet to conclude, but someone had always searched for Jin Yan's entire outfit and tidily arranged her findings in a long Weibo post. She first released a photo of Jin Yan at the festival, then began breaking down her outfit, starting with her coat. Light yellow coat, Maggie's latest spring collection, selling price of 28,600 yuan. Lace double-layered blouse, Bunny's latest spring collection, 10,800 yuan. Beige midi skirt, Bunny's latest spring collection, 15,080 yuan. Pale yellow high heels, Bureau's latest spring collection, Country Pacific price not yet released. White bow, Lily and Sa's latest spring collection, 2,300 yuan. I only want to say one thing, instructor ought to draw manhwa. The fans who didn't attend the event all commented on the post. At first I wanted to wear the same outfit as Teacher Tung Si's. Now it seems that I thought too much. Wait a bit more, very soon there will be invitations, Doge. Holy shit, Tung Si really is gorgeous. Ellis Master He lucked out of her. Love Viper is such a strong competitor. I feel that in this lifetime, I'll not be able to win back my hubby's nonsense heart. Smile. I didn't manage to grab a ticket to the festival. Cries. I also want to be there to see Teacher Tung Si. Cries. Those high heels really are fucking beautiful. Cries. Can Teacher Tung Si release a small tutorial on planning outfits on Weibo? I want to study. Actually, anything Weibo people wear is beautiful, but if you wear the same thing, it might not have the same result. Anyone, you better make foots make money. Otherwise, you might not be able to afford what buying what Teacher Tung Si recommends. Smart cry. Wait a minute. Isn't this the beautiful sales lady who previously worked at Fancy Wardrobe? She gave me a clue of recommendations and left an extremely profound impression on me. Discussion on Weibo was enthusiastic. Meanwhile, the autograph signing at the festival also proceeded like wildfire. Although the collection edition price was relatively high, the amount of people lining up was small. For that half-hour autograph signing session, Jin Yan had nearly no breaks until it was impossible for her to even sign her name quickly afterwards. Herschel, anxious about the fans attacking, didn't show up either. After the anime festival, Jin Yan directly entered Herschel's call rather than Lin Zhen's. I'm dead tired. I don't want to have another autograph signing even after half a year. Jin Yan leaned against the passenger seat, twisting her wrist. Herschel chuckled and seized her right hand, massaging it for her. So I massage it for you? Jin Yan ended up relaxing, having no qualms about others enjoying Ellis Master He's service. The organizers didn't invite you to a meal? Herschel inquired. They did, but I turned them down peacefully. Then what do you want to eat for lunch? Jin Yan thought for a moment, before glancing at him and saying, how about we return home to eat something homemade? Alright. Herschel raised her hand, smiling as he started the car. After snow, expressing thanks to sponsors. End of chapter 58.